眼下，成都大运会各个赛场激战正酣，在各个比赛场馆和媒体中心都能看到乌干达、塞内加尔、巴基斯坦、泰国、日本等国家记者忙碌的身影。8月3号上午7点，日本籍记者大金泉一郎早早登上了前往田径赛场的媒体班车，开启一天的赛事报道。第一次来到中国的他说，自己一走出机场就感受到了这座城市的热情。
组织方提供的服务让我很震惊，从一开始下飞机就有志愿者接机，这是让我感到震惊的第一点。接下来就是日常关于日语的翻译支持，我感觉很有帮助，因为我之前没有来过中国，对成都也不了解，只对四川料理有一些了解。来了成都之后，我觉得城市很大也很整洁，这边的工作人员和人们都很热情，就是这边天气有点热。
在汇聚全球媒体记者的主媒体中心，外籍记者们每天在这里将大量新闻报道传向世界，让更多人认识了解成都大运会。
Every day we collect news about this game. First day we share different news about opening ceremony and publishing many medias and many people views our news. We broadcast also in our television. We broadcast different news report. Every day we work that type of reporting.
Very nice working environment. I already did a story about it on my website, like how smooth the place is, how convenient it is for all the sport journalists. I think like the organizing committee have did good on offering this kind of space, very convenient with all the necessary stuff you may need. Having coffee from time to time, they boost our energy. And then having colleagues all around, you feel in a working environment, but at the same time, you feel like in a safe place, in a family environment, because we all friends, we all brothers from different parts of the world. And I think that this is very something we really appreciate.
书法、唐人、武术、川剧、茶艺，主媒体中心还专门设置了中国文化体验的休闲区域，成为全球记者的网红打卡地。除了进行专业快速的赛事报道，外籍记者们也将中国传统非遗、城市风光、大熊猫等列入了报道计划。
We visit some beautiful places, Chengdu, some tourist area, some historical place, some garden and some market, and we collect some video. And when we go back to our country, then we will publish online and television. This is our plan.
目前我还是聚焦赛事，还没有文化相关的拍摄计划。接下来可能会去拍摄一些体操、游泳方面的比赛。我可能会等这次全部的比赛拍摄结束后，自行前往成都大熊猫繁育研究基地之类的景点拍摄。
And I, yeah, so we've come here just to sort of report on the different sports and games. Also do some lifestyle reporting about Chengdu itself. I've been to Chengdu many times, but we want to do some content about sort of life in Chengdu and sort of the tourist stuff and, you know, kind of what Chengdu's about. And so we're doing sort of dual things.